heard my voice, he rescued me from those who attacked me. Entrust your cares to the Lord, and he will support you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Prompt our actions with your inspiration, we pray, O Lord, and further them with your constant help, that all we do may always begin from you, and by you be brought to completion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Today I have set before you life and prosperity, death and doom. If you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I enjoin on you today, loving him and walking in his ways and keeping his commandments, statutes, and decrees, you will live and grow numerous, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land you are entering to occupy. If, however, you turn away your hearts and will not listen, but are led astray and adore and serve other gods, I tell you now that you will certainly perish, that you will not have a long life on the land that you are crossing the Jordan to enter and occupy. I call heaven and earth today to witness against you. I have set before you life and death, the blessing and the curse. Choose life then, that you and your descendants may live by loving the Lord your God, heeding his voice and holding fast to him. For that will mean life for you, a long life for you to live on the land of the Lord, that the Lord swore that he would give your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Repent, says the Lord, the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
killed, and on the third day be raised. Then he said to all, if anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. What profit is there for one to gain the whole world, yet lose or forfeit himself? The Gospel of the Lord. Our readings from yesterday, today, and certainly in the days to come, we're being given the playbook for a good and fruitful Lent. And today we have two calls, and they're both C terms. The first call is the call to conversion given to us from Moses. The second is the call to cross, the call to carry your cross every day. And we've heard this phrase many times. Sometimes we can kind of gloss over it, I know I do. But imagine what it was like to be an apostle and to receive these words for the first time. To hear your master speaking about his own upcoming death, and then to tell you to take up your cross. Keeping in mind how brutal the cross is, this is not an easy teaching. I would place it up as probably the second hardest teaching. The first hardest being, unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you shall not have life within you. The teachings of Jesus are hard. But, as we'll learn with Lent, sacrifice is hard. And because these things are hard, they have more value to them. That's why we advocate for giving up something good or doing something substantial. The harder it is, the more trying it is for you, the more valuable it is in the eyes of God. And the more value we have to give to God and say, look, I'm making this sacrifice and I'd like to ask for blank. A great sacrifice has greater value. Jesus calls us to the ultimate sacrifice, which is the cross. There is no sacrifice greater than that. And we're called to take it up daily. This is not easy, but it is so worthwhile. And it makes me think of, there's a bit of a paradox with happiness. You would think that taking up your cross every day, following Moses' call to conversion, walking the hard road, you would think that this would be burdensome, tiring, not fun. And that can be present sometimes. It will be. And yet, those who take this path ultimately end up more fulfilled and happy than anyone else in the world. Doesn't quite make sense to me. Those who listen to the world's message of do whatever makes you happy are the ones who end up with a midlife crisis, while those who hand themselves over totally to the will of the Father, I think of religious sisters and brothers, those are some of the happiest people that I've seen, yet by the world's standards they would say that they have the most restrictions imposed on them, that they are the least free. Paradoxically, though, there they are, in their happiness. I think of Mother Mary Catherine and the sisters up in Door County, some of the happiest sisters I have ever seen. And yet, some would say that they are the most restricted, that they take up their cross, that they live a hard life, that they've taken a difficult path. That is, that's true. Both of them are true. And that's where the little paradox kicks in. We live in that tension. We have a hard call, one that is difficult, one that will have moments of pain. Certainly, if the cross is involved, there will be pain. I would say if there wasn't pain, then you're not taking up your cross. And yet, in the midst of this, in the journey, even before we reach the final end, we experience this fulfillment, this happiness, this internal pervading peace in following our Lord Jesus. So do I understand it? Gosh, no. Do any of us understand it, really? No one thinks so. Yet, it is the truth. It is what is given to us by Jesus, and we can trust it with our whole hearts. We can embrace the cross, even though it may seem to be a scary and difficult thing, trusting in the words of our Master. We pray this day for the strength to take up our cross. It is not an easy task. Thankfully, the Lord is ready to give us His because we live so far in the future, you could say, there are many more saints in heaven right now than there were centuries ago. And each and every one of these saints is rallying for us. Each and every one of them is ready and eager to keep working in heaven. I think I mentioned St. Teresa of Lisieux before. How she said she wants to spend her time in heaven doing good on earth. I believe there are many saints like her. The more time that passes, the further into the future we get. Even if things begin to look a little bleak, there are more and more saints added to that heavenly banquet. And they are eager to help us. I think that we should be eager to ask for their help as well. With such a multitude of support, we'll be just fine. Together we offer to our Heavenly Father these our petitions.
For those who share faith in Jesus as the Messiah, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who proclaim to others Christ's good news, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who take up Christ's cross in pursuit of justice and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who deny themselves to serve the oppressed and the forgotten, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who share the Son of Man's suffering in sickness, grief, and pain, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our intention today for Joe Zimmer, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hope to be raised with Christ on the third day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for an increase of vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, and for the sanctification of our priests. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we humbly ask you to help us convert from sin and to carry our cross daily. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the divine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Holy Church.
Regard with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings we set upon this sacred altar, that, bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Your faithful await the sacred Paschal feasts with the joy of minds made pure, so that, more eagerly intent on prayer and the works of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis uncedi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
History of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, whose wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for life. safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power of our Lord and our God is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
That's right.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Create a pure heart for me, O God, renew a steadfast spirit within me.
Please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you. blessing of your heavenly gifts, we humbly beseech you, Almighty God, that they may always be for us the source both of pardon and of salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, who have made known to your people the ways of eternal life, lead them by that path, we pray, to you the unfading light. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.